For fast, cheap, and reliable coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuntReserve.com. Head over to MuntReserve.com. They're awesome to work with. They got super cheap, fast, and reliable coins. Make sure you use code Poodle at checkout for an additional 15% off your order.
What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today I'm going to be going over a bunch of updates. Good morning, Madden's finally back, as you can see by the screen. Not to say that, you know, it's a banger Good Morning Madden Day. Of course, this is the first day back in the studio, so things are going to be a little bit lighter. But there's plenty of updates, not so much content. There is one thing that did come out today that I'm going to go over, but a few things that are coming out, a few updates and notices that we probably all were wondering. Just like an overall list of things that have just kind of like been a question within the community. Like I said, they did just get back to the office today, so we have to expect that things may be a bit slower. Although, hopefully, they can get on as fast as possible and get the content chain moving again. But before we get into the video, guys, make sure to go below, hit that subscribe button, turn the notification bell, like the video. And of course, if you guys do need coins, pick up some players, poster, or chill, or save for some of the playoff promo, team of the week, or team of the year, head over to Mount Reserve and use code Poodle for the 30% discount that is still going on. Like I said, not sure how long it will go on for, so make sure you are taking advantage of it. Now, first thing I do want to go over is going to be the team of the week aspect, or actually, let's start with the exchange set real quick. So let's come over to the exchange sets here. If you see Ghost of Madden, they did say there was supposed to be some new ones, so I'm just going to cycle through. If you guys see any new ones that you guys didn't see before, Ghost of Madden Future or an 88 plus. I feel like it's these right here, but so you put in pretty much low 80s and you get an 88 plus. So essentially, that's how you can get the Simmons and the Kamara and all those guys for pretty cheap if you have the players sitting in your binder here. The hardest one's going to be the Ghost of Madden Past. Let's see if out of position has anything. Out of position player. And then, of course, we have the Zero Chill player, Zero Chill Hero, Snow Beast plus Beast Food, and then random Frozen player plus Hot Cocoa, which that's always been there. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Some exchange sets for all you exchange guys. Next, get to the team of the week news real quick. Team of the week news coming on over to over here. Team of the weeks 14, 15, 16, and 17 will be releasing now. 14 and 15 is going to be releasing the 12th. And then 15 and 16 is going to be releasing the 19th. So what that says about a lot of things here is that content may be delayed. Or that team of the week will be coming out. The final one will come out after team of the year. Which wouldn't really make too much sense now. If I remember correctly, Team of the Year landed last year on the 13th and the 14th. Like I said, I remember because I was on vacation and I had to record out of the country pretty much. And it was a mess overall. But it did definitely lead to me remembering the dates of Team of the Week, or Team of the Year, I should say. If you guys don't know, Team of the Year is pretty much the culmination of all the Team of the Weeks 1 through 17. You gotta get the free player. Now, considering it, technically, if we follow this line, first off, playoff promo released last year today. So that means that playoff promo is already delayed, and since it's a lighter content week, so it's looking like the playoff promo may not start until early, like late this week or early next week. So that does mean the playoff promo is going to be about a week delayed. Now, what that also means is that with Team of the Week coming out the 12th, that essentially means, and Team of the Week coming out the 19th, if everything stands the same way, that Team of the Year shouldn't come out until after the 19th. Now, could they drop before? They could, but more than likely, we won't be seeing Team of the Year until after the 20th, or at least the 19th at bare minimum. And at that point, unless it comes out 19th at night, which would make sense as well, like Team of the Week drops in the morning, and the 19th we start Team of the Year promo. Now, here's the thing. Last year, it was playoff promo was the 4th, and then, you know, Team of the Year was the 13th or the 14th, and then Super Bowl promo was the week of the 20th. So now, with Team of the Year being the week of the 23rd, they're going to pretty much combine the Super Bowl and the Team of the Year into, like, the same week, and not even, you know, bracket them off, or they're going to be, or they even push back Super Bowl promo a little bit, so that we just get it, like, right at the Super Bowl, which typically it starts a bit before. And then, of course, you have the Honors promo as well. We got the Pro Bowl stuff, if they give us Pro Bowl stuff this year. So there's just a lot of stuff coming out. But that pretty much covers the content train of stuff that we've like be expecting. So the Team of the Week, as far as that goes, like I said, that's delayed back. And playoffs have been delayed. Now, another thing, guys, is going to be Blitz Quick Sales. For all you guys who did have... Oh, there goes my chill factors. For all you guys... My snow. So all the things just transferred over as well right now. For all you guys who did have Blitz items, remember, as far as Blitz items go, people have been complaining that a lot of Blitz items don't have quick sales, right? Like, if you have any Blitz tokens left over that you didn't use, anything, you can go over, and usually in years past, like, a Blitz CD would quick sell for, like, 15,000 coins, so if you had, like, 20 of them, you can get, you know, a few hundred thousand coins, you can get a pretty decent amount. I remember one year had, like, 150k worth, and it was just a nice little surprise of extra stuff. People are complaining that to this day you can still not quick sell them, there's still no quick sell value, so Kralo did say that he emailed the dev team and have them working on something, so hopefully I just don't within the near future. Another important thing is going to be Barry Sanders. Now, for all you guys who want Barry Sanders, I'm not sure what the census is on you guys right now as far as Barry goes. Do you guys prefer, you know, Alvin Kamara, Bo Jackson. Is Barry Sanders a cheaper option because he's a 50 player? Very possible now. Issue with Barry Sanders is pretty simple. To get him powered up and everything, his power-up costs 300K, right? Which is more than his actual good card, which is right here, 96 overall. And then his diamond card costs 540K. So it essentially would cost you over a million coins power-up alone. No, and it's not including his card. Just the power-up card for 380K plus this card right here would go for a plus training would cost you over a million coins. Then you got to buy his actual card. This card costs you over 1.5 million coins, pretty much just power-up, upgrade, and put abilities on. So what they're working on is the Crayola set is a Barry Sanders training option. So you get the power-up, and when you get to the Team Diamond card, instead of having to buy the Team Diamond card, maybe there'll be a training option for like 10,000 training, 15,000 training, something that's just not as much as this card, and that should save you. I mean, it's still going to be expensive regardless, right? Because at the end of the day, this card plus this card is still costing you over 700K plus abilities, so you're looking at over 800K to power him up regardless, and that's not including whatever the training option is. You're probably looking at close to a million still, but it's going to definitely save like a few hundred thousand coins, so that's pretty good. I mean, I'm not sure if people actually want Barry. I mean, I think they kind of killed him on the speed, personally. I mean, no, he's still an amazing card. He still fits the meta. He still has a crazy change of direction agility and excel that everyone wants, especially if you can't afford the human joystick AP. You just, you know, take advantage of what he naturally has. But again, the thing with Barry is going to simply be the fact that I think they should have given him a 95 speed. He should not be slower than Bo Jackson by any means. But like I said, he gets the juke. He gets the crazy excel. He gets all the stuff that a lot of other people aren't getting. So he's still going to stand out. He's still probably going to be the best back in the game or one of the best backs. But like I said, it all comes down, again, to how you value certain things if you rather have the speed on Bo. But just like early in the year, Bo was faster than Barry. And Barry was still better. So, you know, and Barry still has some short hour running as well. And a few little cool things that, you know, Bo may not have. But anyways, moving on from that, that's that update. Next, we have a series is coming. They did announce before the holiday break that sometime shortly after they came back, so probably within the week or the next week, we will be getting a series update. So that would mean next new levels, which means we'll be getting to level 80, I believe. So again, another level of grind. Easy coins. If you know money spent, maybe you don't do those packs. You can just take the free stuff. But if you do those packs, you know those packs are typically a really great way to just get a ton of free stuff or even cheap stuff, I should say. So that should be coming. Hopefully a new series update. Maybe finally some gauntlet stuff. Maybe some cool solos related to series. Maybe a new type of grind. Some redux cards and LTDs. We've gotten a lot of LTDs. It's been a while just LTD after LTD. So all those LTDs will finally start getting some redux cards, which should lead to some cheaper players to pick up. And probably, you know, an increase of pack odds, which should effectively kill the market, which should bring down the market again. You know, the whole circle of life that we have in Madden. Next, guys, is the Snowball fight. Snowball fight is finally coming to a resolution. Well, it came to a resolution like 7 days ago, but finally we'll be getting the completed players, right? So Zero Chill, it's out of here now. So apparently, sometime tonight they said it with the server, some were down with what they were doing. As of tonight, once the Snowball fight, you know, results are concluded, we'll be seeing Miles Garrett get the plus one or Justin Herbert get the plus one. Now, Crayola made it sound like it was going to be Miles Garrett who won. Again, not sure. It seemed like everyone was pushing for Herbert, so not really conclusive on that one. But we will know, as of today, who gets the plus one, hopefully, and we will see the plus one happen. I mean, if it's delayed any longer, probably until tomorrow. But it's not going to be that, you know, that delayed in comparison. But that is pretty cool. So if you guys got the Garrett or the Herbert, you'll end up seeing who you get. I personally like Garrett better. Now, I know the community picked Herbert, which I didn't really understand because at the end of the day, Herbert's not getting all the thresholds. So for the most part, he's probably not going to be the quarterback everyone uses. But Miles Garrett has a fill-in ability, you know what I mean? Like, second defensive tackle, first defensive tackle, backup end. Like, you know, there was something for him, I feel like. Especially, like, not on God squads, of course, but on a regular team, he probably could have started for a lot of people. On a regular team, you could probably just afford Aaron Rodgers or a few other guys that are just super cheap that you could just fill in there. And honestly, people would rather pay for a quarterback anyways. But guys, that pretty much wraps up today's video. Hopefully you did enjoy today's updates. We had a lot of updates, you know, it was a lot of unanswered questions, a lot of stuff that had to be answered. So that's definitely great to see that we're finally getting some stuff on that. Because of course, like I said, we haven't had a Good Morning Madden stream since, what was it, the 23rd, 24th, Christmas Eve-ish. So it's been a while, so nice to see that coming back. Yeah, guys, that's about it for the video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, turn on the notification bell, comment down below, like the video, and of course, if you need coins, head over to my reserve and take advantage. I don't know how much longer the 30% will be lasting, so take advantage. Use code Poodle for 30% off your order at checkout. That's about it. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm out.